Hello, my name is Major Ron Hathaway, United States Marine Corps retired. I will be your host today for the Armed Forces Heritage Museum of New Jersey, and today's guest is Eileen Daly, former president of Gold Star Mothers from 2018 to 2021. Welcome. First of all, tell me about yourself.
Oh, it's so good to be here. My name is Eileen Daly, and I'm a Gold Star mother of Sergeant Ronald Kubek. He was my only son. He was killed in action April 23rd, 2010 in Afghanistan, Army Ranger. So I'm very proud of him. He's my hero. And I also have two other daughters, Mary and Amy Kubek. So I'm equally proud of them, very happy to have them. I myself am a nurse. I'm a registered nurse, and I've been a nurse for over 40 years. And I love what I do. I love helping people, and I work in oncology.
So. Tell me more about your son.
He was born June 22, 1988 in Point Pleasant, New Jersey. He was the biggest baby in the nursery. He was 11 pounds. And when he was born, I said, here's my football player. And for his baby picture, I put him in a football jersey. And he was the greatest kid. He was amazing. He was so interested in everything going on. He was a leader from the beginning and had so many friends. And just all the way up when he started school, he was so involved in everything. He was in sports. He played football. He wrestled. He was on the honor roll, straight A's all the way up. He wrote for the newspaper, the school newspaper, Adventures with Ron. He wrote for the Blue and Gold. He was in the drama club. He acted. He loved improvisational comedy. He loved to joke around. And he played the guitar and started a band, A Void Within. You name it, Ronnie did it. He was in everything. And the other students really looked up to him because he was on a mission. He wanted what was the best for everyone. And I can give you a wonderful story. It's one of my favorite stories about Ron in high school. It's called the Green Mohawk story. He decided that he was going to cut his hair into a mohawk and dye it green, bright green. So he showed up in Manasquan High School with this green mohawk. And of course, they called him into the principal's office and they said, well, this is against our dress code. And they said, but Ron, if you really feel led to do this, we'll let you go in front of the Board of Education. We'll let you present your case. You can interview teachers. And he really was just making a statement about self-expression. It wasn't that he had to wear it, but it was just that's the way he was. He was the leader. And he did. He interviewed teachers. He presented his case in front of the Board of Education, and he won. They changed the dress code, and the next day he cut it off and dyed his hair back to brown. But that's the way he was. And he said, Mom, I'm doing this for future generations of kids to have the right of self-expression. That's the way he thought. And then when he was 17, he came home from school and he said, Mom, I want to be a Marine. The recruiters came to school today and I really want to join. And I said, Ron, I know you need me to sign, but let's wait another year. When you're 18, if you still want to go into the service, you can sign. I said, you know, have another year. So he said, okay. So in the meantime, being he was on the honor roll all the way up, they advised him to go on to college to become a lawyer. And he actually did start Brookdale College. He went for 6 months. However, on 2007, in Valentine's Day, I came home with a box of chocolates for him, and he had the news for me that he signed up. He signed up and he said, Mom, I went in and I said, I will only sign up if I can be an airborne ranger. That was his heart's goal, to be a ranger. So he did. He signed up. He said, you know what? He was the post 9/11 generation. And he said, Mom, I can't look the other way. He said, I have to go and fight. And I said, okay, Ron, and he signed up, and I supported him. He went off to Ranger school, and he got his Ranger tab, and he went to airborne school, and he had three deployments, one to Afghanistan, one to Iraq, and then another one to Afghanistan. And he became sergeant and rifle squad team leader, and he was only 21 years old. On his third deployment to Afghanistan, he gave his life for our country, April 23rd, 2010. Mm-hmm. And I want to share that story with you. He had just become sergeant and team leader. He had his own team, and they were tracking a high-value target in Afghanistan. This was an Al-Qaeda. This target actually transported weapons for the IEDs, you know, the different materials, the explosives, and for suicide bombers. So they were tracking him, and they got word where he was. And as you know, in Afghanistan, it's not like our country where we live in little houses. They live in compounds. And this high-value target was hiding behind women and children. They have so many families in a compound, as you know. So they got the word they had to go. So it was the middle of the night. And they actually tracked him down. They got to the compound. But because of rules of engagement then, they had to let him know that they were there and give him a chance to surrender. Now, you know, that doesn't happen. But of course, so when they got to the compound, they started throwing bangers against the doors to like wake everybody up that we're here, do you want to surrender? So meanwhile, there was a sniper on the roof, and here was Ronnie and the Rangers in the courtyard. And the Afghan partner unit worked with Ronnie's unit. So they had sent them in initially because the compound was full of women and children. So they wanted the Afghan partner unit, which spoke the language, get the women and children out of the compound first so they can go in to confront this high-value target. So they were starting to get the women and children out, but the sniper on the roof shot down at the Rangers. So they shot up, killed the sniper. His body fell off the roof into the center of the courtyard. All the women and children got scared and ran back into the building. So Ron, leading from the front the way he was, he initiated a team to go into the building, and he led from the front. So he got into the building first, but by then, my son was in the stairwell. The high-value target was on top of the stairwell with an AK-47. So he started shooting at Ronnie, and he shot 7 rounds at close distance with this AK, armor-piercing bullets at close round. And my son started climbing the stairs, shooting back, screaming to everyone, letting them know what was going on. And he didn't stop shooting until the high-value target actually broke contact. What amazes me is how did he keep going up the stairs and get 7 bullets and kept going? And he saved 29 people that day, 19 women and children and 10 soldiers. And then he succumbed to his wounds. So that is my hero. And posthumously, he was awarded the Meritorious Service Medal, the Purple Heart, 2 Bronze Stars, 1 with V device, and the Silver Star. And the Silver Star is, as you know, the Army's 3rd highest military award for combat and valor. So my son is my hero, and he loved our country. And I want to share a quote written by Ron. "We are here on Earth, and we have the opportunity to do something truly great. Find a topic you believe in and fight for it. Make your dream a reality." And that's exactly what Ronnie did. He loved this country and he fought for us. And he just was such a leader, and he gave his life. And shortly after that, a couple of Rangers who were saved that night drove from Georgia to my house with a marble monument. And on it said, "Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends." So they were so truly touched. So that's my hero.
Well said, well said.
Thank you.
When did you actually become a Gold Star mother after that?
Well, after that, when I got the news, I was actually at work because I'm a nurse, and they were the casualty assistance officer, but the officer that does inform you with the chaplain were looking for me. So I was at my daughter's house when they came to the door, and I just caved to the floor. I just was speechless. I just went into shock. And we started calling family and friends, and they came over to support us. And then at my son's viewing, that's when I first heard about being a Gold Star mother. I didn't know what a Gold Star mother was. I didn't know what a Blue Star mother was. I had never heard those terms before. And at the viewing, a group of Gold Star mothers and Gold Star families came up to me, and they told me, they said, "Now you're a Gold Star mother, and you're a member of a club no one wants to join." And I said, club, Gold Star mothers, I don't know what that is. I said, I already am a member of a club. I'm the member of the Toastmasters Club. I had no clue. But that was my introduction to exactly what a Gold Star mother is. And then it went there on from there. But it was just...
How did they support you?
Oh my goodness. You know, Gold Star mothers have been such a support because no one understands the way we understand because we've been through it. So when they say, I know how you feel, they've experienced that same loss. So they supported me through the understanding and through the different things that we do to honor veterans. You know, one thing I learned early on was that grief is an energy. And if you keep it inside, it's self-destructive. So you have to use that energy for good, for other people. And my goal as a Gold Star mother has always been to carry on my son's legacy of making a difference in this world. And I always wanted my son to be proud of me. So I try to carry it, to do that, to make a difference. And through the Gold Star Mothers, they gave me many opportunities to help veterans, help other families, other Gold Star families, and it's just been such a strength and a support for me.
Sure. Now, I understand that you became president of the organization.
Yes, I did. So I got very involved with the Gold Star Mother organization, and I was president. It started out, I was honor guard for 4 years, and then I was vice president for 2 years, and then I was president for 2 years. So, and I was just so honored to be able to do that. It really, really was an amazing experience.
How would you like your legacy to be remembered as president?
I want my legacy to be remembered as someone, as a Gold Star Mother that made a difference, that actually inspired people through the life of her son, and that I mirrored my son's victory, my son being a hero, that I actually was a reflection, because that's all I always wanted to do was, like, I didn't want them to see me. I wanted them to see my son. And I want them to remember that I was dedicated and devoted. I reached out to the members of and this was actually through the COVID. The first year, I was active in a lot of events, but the second year COVID hit. So I reached out to those Gold Star mothers in virtually to let them know I was still there. We were still a part of each other, even though we couldn't physically meet, they still had the support. And when there was a new Gold Star mother, I reached out to her and spent several hours on the phone and just embraced her and supported her the way I was embraced and supported. And the first time we had, usually we get together for our meetings in person, but we had to have a virtual meeting, so that was a challenge. But I want to be remembered for that virtual meeting, because that really went quite well. We did the whole meeting. It was like Hollywood Squares on Zoom, but it really was amazing. And I had a guest speaker, and I just had new members that were on that day. And it was just like everybody loved it, you know. It was so, I want to be remembered as the president that continued to love the members and be there for them and be supportive. And then we have Wreaths Across America, where they give wreaths to the Gold Star families to put on the grave of their hero. They did not make a stop for the COVID year. So guess what? The Wreaths Across America delivered the wreaths for the Gold Star mothers into my garage. So I had the Gold Star mothers coming to my home to hand them their wreath, and they just appreciated that so much. So it was an amazing experience, and I'm just so honored to have been given that opportunity to serve, and I just want Ronnie to be proud of me, and I'm sure he is, you know. So
what affiliation did you have with a veteran organization like the VFWs?
I'm a member of the VFW, the Auxiliary, and I'm in the process of becoming a member of the American Legion Auxiliary also. I'm very active whenever they have different events and they invite Gold Star mothers. And I love public speaking, as you could tell. But I love to go and talk about Ron and just talk about our veterans and how proud I am of them and thank you for their service. And I just have such a place in my heart. And thank you for your service.
Is there anything else you'd like to add before we conclude?
Of course. I'd like to add a few ways that I'm still staying active to help the Gold Star community. I'm on a Pentagon committee called the SOG, the Survivor Advisory Working Group. And it's 12 members from across the country. And we work on survivor issues and ways to make it easier for other survivors. So we meet twice a year. We usually go to the Pentagon, but because of COVID, we've been doing Microsoft Teams meetings. And so I'm working on that now, and there's a sibling issue that I'm bringing forward that I'm proud of. And so I've been doing that for 3 years. So that will be coming to a conclusion this year. But I felt so blessed that I was in an opportunity when I was president and on the SOG to bring any issues from the Gold Star families right to the Pentagon. I used to send the emails. I'd say, I'm on the SOG. Like, is there anything you want me? I'm a conduit right now, you know? So that was really exciting, too. So that's sure. coming to an end. And also, I wanted to share that Manasquan High School started a scholarship fund for my son, Ron. He touched so many lives, and his two English teachers started a scholarship fund for him, and that's been going on for 10 years, and I'm very involved with that. Every year, they have a show in his honor, Improv for Ron, because my son loved comedy. That was the best way to honor him, being in the drama club, and I bring Ron's pictures, and I bring him to life, and I talk to the parents and the students about my son, so that helps me a lot, too, because he's just loved so much. He's still touching lives. And then also, they have the Run for the Fall, and I'm involved with that through the Gold Star families. So we start from Cape May. There's a group of runners. They're active duty veterans, and they run all the way from Cape May to Homedale. And they run a mile for each fallen hero in the state of New Jersey that was involved with the War on Terror. So it's 194 miles they ran this year. So my son's mile marker is in front of the Manasquan High School. And so I'm involved with that. I go down to Cape May, and I follow them through and support them for the whole journey. And we also have PetSmart donates stuffed animals every year to the Gold Star mothers, and we give them to charities. So Catholic charities, so there's a group of us that do that on the committee. So I pick up bags of these huge stuffed animals from PetSmart, and I deliver them to Catholic charities. I deliver them to the St. Vincent de Paul Society, bags to there. So I'm looking forward to that. So we're starting that up again. And that's it. Any way I can stay involved, it really helps me. And I've just met amazing people on this journey. And I just want to be remembered as someone that, you know, loved my hero. Wanted to keep making a difference for him and helping and supporting people and our veterans.
Well, we want to thank you very much for coming in, Eileen, and it was a great conversation with you and about your son, and we're so proud of you and your son.
Thank you.
And today we've been talking to Eileen Daly, and she was one of Gold Star Mothers, and thank you for watching.